Hey folks, it's Paul Roberts, Artsy1. Today I want to just tell you about this new cape I'm working on. Now, I've been working on latex capes, all latex capes, in several different ways for over a decade now. I've actually been working on some new type of materials that go into the latex. I want to show how this is going to move. This is a very, very light cape and the strongest one I've ever made. Now, you've got some variables here that you might like. This particular one still sounds pretty good. A little lighter weight though, not quite like the bat wing of the bigger ones. Also, there's no seam on the front here, it's just a cut. It's nice and clean, but you know, some people like the seam or a little bit more thickness there. This cape is the smallest, tightest, strongest cape yet. We're looking at less than 4 pounds here. We're looking at super, super thin, a super strong type of bonding special technique that I use is used to create this cape. Now this right here, I want to always point this out to you. Depending on how broad your shoulders are and how hefty you are, you may have a little bit of some extra slack here, especially if you've got a reinforced one that has the fabric through here. The thing to do is to cut this right here and squeeze it in, overlap it, and re-glue it so that there's no slack. Now, if you don't have the reinforced one, but just the really heavy-duty latex cape, this won't be a problem because the rest of it will flow around the shoulders even better, and then this will go taut once the cowl is on, is really the way to decide. But you know, there's a very good chance that if I were to add Velcro to this, the slack could just be taken up by just folding it over like this. You may not have to cut it. You could actually fold it over and put the Velcro on, and if these line up right here with the symbol, then everything will be good. Since it's so strong, it can be worn over the shoulders. Now this particular cape doesn't look very good over the shoulders like this, because I don't have the cowl and the symbol in place. But it's not going to hurt you right around your throat because it's nice and light. However, I do still recommend a harness going underneath your suit and around so that you can take all the weight off and pull this down in front. So let's go ahead and see how it flaps. But this is very, very strong. We can flap this as hard as we want and nothing will happen. It doesn't have the feeling, perhaps, of the bigger ones. You know, the menacing feeling. But it's got the ability to do things with it. One of the things that I'm going to be doing with my cape is putting the little weights in the bottom. Okay? Now, you can already whap them in the face. Okay, now I've never seen Batman do anything like this yet, but what he ought to be able to do is just simply take his cape and to the face, distract, and then, you know, just like that. Which is really nice because if you just came at the guy and you didn't have the cape, he'd be ready for you. So one of the things you want to do with this cape is use it as a weapon. It's super strong. We can simply take it off. Now, one of the things that this is good for is to get on top of something. If I were to wrap this around, wrap it tight enough, it can pretty much hold your weight. Get you about anywhere you need to go. So you're getting ready for a knockdown, drag-out fight. The last thing you want is this around, perhaps. Maybe if you learn to handle it, it's all right. You've got instant gratification. I've got several choices. I can go for the gun, go for the face distraction. I can try to do the total right, or I could do a combination. So something like that. But the great thing about the cape is, if you have a strong enough one, you can rely on it as a weapon. You can reach farther than anybody can get to you. Farther than your leg, farther than anybody can reach you. And like I say, if you take it off, you've got a projectile. We go back and retrieve our cape, which is perfectly fine. Of course, nothing's gonna phase this thing. Of course, it can handle the roll. Now, a thicker cape can help you with the roll, but if you've got a soft surface or a smooth surface, you really don't need the thicker cape. Just like that. And your cape is in 100% shape. You might get a little dirt on it, but we're ready to go again. No need for outfit. So, anyway, once he's mopped up, or had the police or whoever mop up, try again the next day. So that's about everything you can do with a strong cape. And of course, why use the elevator? Just make sure you're secure. And down you go. This is Paul Roberts, RC1, saying, till next time.